Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Kanya and if you are new here, I am a social media as well as personal branding coach. I help nano influencers go from stuck, overwhelmed and not growing to absolutely thriving and using their influence, no matter how small, to make money. So if that sounds like you, then you've come to the right place. And what we usually do here is give a little shout out to the comment of the day. So I want to do that real quick. And today's comment of the day goes to Call Me Cool Friend Kim. As a creator and entrepreneur, this will really help me build my business, plus help me save a lot of coin as this is something I need. Listen, first of all, I'm going to say this without getting emotional, but like that is literally the point of my everything. I'm just trying to help nano influencers, do not cry. I'm trying to help nano influencers as well as digital creatives and entrepreneurs just thrive. So if you want to be the comment of the day tomorrow, next week, next month, whenever it is, then make sure you leave me a comment down below. So my notes are all here, okay? This is how ready I am to be here, okay? I'm gonna cut all the shit and just give it to you straight because there is a lot of trash online when it comes to how to grow your Instagram. Let me give you the secret sauce, okay? Let me give you exactly how to grow on social media in general. It is a two-step process. I've spoken about this before. Step one, you need a marketing strategy to bring new eyes onto your platform. Step two, you need a conversion strategy to turn those new eyes into followers, subscribers, whatever they are called on your social media platform. There is nothing else. That is it. You bring them in and you keep them. You bring them in and you keep them. And that is how you grow and you grow and you grow. Yes, there are other details such as once you bring them in, what does it actually mean to keep them? It means, for example, they subscribe, they follow, but it also means that they buy into your community. And then above that, it means that they buy into you, the person. And I have given you a few tips and things to consider when creating these two strategies on my IGTV. So go and check out both of these videos over here after you have completed this video, because then it's just the trifecta. And what I want to do today is go into even more details about what you should be thinking about when creating your marketing as well as conversion strategies. So if you are ready for that, let's get into it. So the first thing you need to really consider when creating your strategy is that you need to get in front of the camera and on video. Show your face. Show your face. Here's why. If you want people to connect with your account, your platform, you provide value. But if you want them to connect to you, the person, then you need to show up and you need to show your face. It is harder and takes way, way longer for people to develop empathy for a graphic or for a logo. So if you want to speed up that process, then you need to show your face. How many times can I say that? One more time. Show your face. Let them know that there is a real life person behind this account. There is someone there with history, family, relationships, issues, as well as advice that they can connect to. And if you want to be a successful digital entrepreneur or a successful influencer, more specifically with a personal brand, then yes. Yes, it really and truly is that deep. Moving on to my next tip, you need to collaborate. Your strategies have to include collaborations. As a nano influencer, the most impactful, could I say, way for you to get in front of the right people is by connecting with the right people. And I don't mean collaboration in this superficial way that I think a lot of content creators, both big and small, have adopted. Yes, there definitely is a time and a place for those more on the surface kind of giveaways and collabs and all of that. But what I'm talking about is creating and being a part of collaborations that have real impact. When creating these collaborations, have some end goals. And I'm going to give you some goals that I think are an amazing place to start off with. Number one, you want to make sure that you're getting in front of the right people. And a really easy way to do this is by collaborating with someone who is already a thought leader or some kind of a leader inside of your specific niche. Number two, you want to make sure that you start to solidify yourself as an authoritative figure. Make sure that during that collaboration, that people know that you know exactly what you are talking about, that you are an authoritative figure. Number three, you want to make sure that you introduce yourself as well as encourage people to follow you. Make it easy for them to find you. Tell them your handle, tell them what you do, tell them your name. Lastly, you want to connect with them. So you want to show them that you are a real person. Show them your personality, because oftentimes that is why people will end up following you, because they'll be like, oh damn, she's a boss, or damn, I love her energy and I just want, you know, more of that, or whatever it is. Show them who you are. If you do not have strategies in place that can tick off all of those boxes when you are collaborating, then that collaboration is more on the superficial surface level. And just to give you an idea with regards to collaborations, you can do IG lives where you interview a thought leader, ask smart questions, establish yourself as an authoritative figure. Make sure that you are using that time not just to market them, but also to market you. Oftentimes, I find that nano influencers, when you are hosting these questions and you are hosting these IG live interviews, you almost fall into the background and you're doing your utmost best to make the other person shine, which is perfectly fine, but you also want to make sure that you are shining as well. Does that make sense? Are you understanding exactly where I'm coming from? And if you are, then let me know down below. Additionally, if you are struggling to get in front of the camera and to even reach out to people, let me know why down below. I do want to create a video on how to get confident in front of the camera and how to start connecting with people via video and showing your face. And I feel that if you let me know what your specific issues are with getting in front of the camera, then that video becomes way more valuable to you. Number three, you need to inject a lifestyle element to your strategy. At the end of the day, what you really, really want is for people to connect with you, the person, and you need to give them the opportunity to do that. And the way you do that is by creating lifestyle content. And I did recently explain this to my impact influencers way, way more in depth, but just to get you started and really thinking about it, the gist of it is that you want people to fall in love with you. You want your products, your platforms, whatever it is, to bring them in and to definitely nurture them, but you also want to start community building. The most powerful communities online support their faves. Even when their faves are doing the absolute most, their faves could drop the most subpar product ever, and members of that community will jump into the comment section and will jump onto Twitter, Instagram, whatever it is, to defend their fave. To the point even where they start speculating and making things up, where the person themselves has not gone into hiding, but they've, you know, stopped posting, but they've got their community there to continuously defend them, and they don't have to confirm or deny anything. The community is just doing the work. And I'm sure that even you have noticed that. That is what you call a strong community. That is the end goal. You want to build a community that is connected, not just to you, but to each other as well. So, if you have found this in any way helpful, pretty please give it a thumbs up, as well as leave a comment down below and share it with any other nano influencers. I want us to help each other. And if you feel ready to put in the work as a nano influencer and go from someone who's just creating online, which is fine, but you want to start actually making money off of your efforts and your passion and your influence, then go and check out this video over here, as well as check out my course, Impact Influencer. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.